Commander of the Navy, Deputy Chief of Staff, now Chief of Staff, I believe. Flag officers, senior officers, junior officers, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. And firstly, let me thank you for a wonderful evening, a lovely dinner, and fantastic company. It's been a long time since I joined the Navy. 35 years is a long time, but like my friend and batchmate told you, it seems very short when you're at the end. I'm at the end of the road as far as the Navy goes. It is the beginning of a new phase of life, and a new door opens for me from today. From today, I serve myself. My Mondays will be good days. I will be sleeping, you will be working. That's the beauty of retirement. We have our own time. But the new road ahead is going to be an exciting one, I'm sure. This time I'm clear because I have reached, I believe, the pinnacle of where any Navy officer can reach. I have been the commander for a short time, but the beauty of this short stint is that it gives me the satisfaction of ending a career, and at the same time gives me time enough to do something for myself. I'm not going to speak about what I have done, nor am I going to speak about what others have done, but what I will speak about is what we expect to be done and what we expect the Navy to be as we go into the future. There is a dream that all of us have when we join a force. And as you understand the force, you, as a very young officer, begin to see and experience many other navies. You begin to experience other navies that are much bigger than yours, other navies that are far more experienced than yours. And you want, the dream is to make your Navy as good or better. In our time, which some would consider unfortunate, we fought a war. And I believe, as a warrior, there is no other expectation than to fight or to die in war. That is what we joined the force for. That is why we serve. And that is why we are servicemen. When I was in the North, I also spoke about the same thing on service. We are here to serve. We are here to serve the people of this country. And don't ever forget that we serve the people and we don't serve ourselves. And that is the message I have to give you today. Serve the people of this country. And to do that, you need to have a few pillars that are very, very important. Courage, moral courage, discipline, professionalism, and above all of this, integrity. That is the pillar on which, that is the ethos of the standing of a good officer. To be able to stand to look into the eye of anybody and have the courage to say what you want to say, because you have the integrity to say it. That is what naval officer is. And that is what I would propose all of you should achieve. If you can do that, you have achieved everything that a man in uniform should achieve. Unfortunately, in the last few years, after the war, we have seen issues that have been brought up against the Navy, and it has tarnished the image of the Navy. We cannot have that anymore. We should not have it, because we are far better than that. The people of this country should know that the men in white are the best that they have got. We are the first line of defense. We are the ones who guard this country at day and at night. We are the guardians of this nation. Remember that it is not the army or the air force. It is the Navy. This is the Navy that we need to build. This is the way we have to move forward. This is what we have to convince the government. This is why we need to win the hearts and minds of the people, for them to know that this is the force that can protect and take the island nation to the next level of development. That is why we need a strong Navy. Today we can see in the Indian Ocean, Sri Lanka stands as a jewel in the crown, right? And we are the officers who are in the Navy at this point that is so important for the nation. So it is important that we show our professionalism to the world, so that we become the locus, we become the hub of this ocean as we move into the future. So gentlemen, again, I wish you that you achieve that dream. Many of you have many years to go, and I want you all to stand and achieve that dream for the Navy. Stand tall, stand strong, and go ahead with taking the Navy to the next level. We are one of the best littoral warfare navies in the world. Remember that. Lots of people don't realize that that is the case. It is the case, there is no doubt. We are one of the most battle-hardened navies in the world when it comes to littoral war. I have been lecturing on this in many places, and I have seen the response that they give me. And there is no doubt about it. We are the best in that facet of war. Be proud about that. Keep that legacy going. Do not let that legacy end. See that that expertise is kept and passed down to your juniors, and that we always hold that secret and take it forward of how to fight when you have to fight close in. Close in fighting is not a simple thing to do. It is done with, it is very dynamic, it is very agile, it is not like fighting standoff. It is fought with a lot of courage, and it is fought with a lot of expertise. The boats may be small, but the maneuver is absolutely unique in warfare, in naval warfare. And that is what we do. And that is why we should stand proud. When you go anywhere and show yourself, that is what they see. They see a unique naval fighting officer. And that is what the Sri Lanka Navy has. And that is why we are proud. Keep that legacy. So gentlemen, let's achieve that dream. When I come back many years from today, I would like to see some of you yet reaching that point or having reached that point. I wish the new commander all the very best with his adventure, and I wish all of you all the very best and your families all the very best. I thank the catering staff, the message students, the band, and all the other staff, people who helped in making this evening a memorable one for me. It is my last day in uniform, probably this is the last uniform I wear, but I will remember this particular day. I will remember each one of you and every face here. Thank you for all your support. I enjoyed leading you when I was the commander. I have enjoyed leading you in many other things too. And I hope you all will remember me. Thank you.